Live streaming on YouTube is one of the best ways to growth hack your YouTube channel and get more views and subscribers. And one of the easiest ways to do it is Streamyard, especially if you want to have dynamic features that are super user friendly. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to set up your stream with Streamyard step by step. And make sure to watch until the end of the video, where I'll be giving you 3 tips for getting more views and boosting your broadcasts. Let's go.
You gotta just press record.
What is up, Sean here, and this is Think Media, a channel devoted to helping you grow your influence with YouTube, live streaming, and video. So if you're new here, consider subscribing, and shout out to Streamyard, the sponsor of this video. Streamyard is our number one solution for live streaming here at Think Media. It's the easiest way to create professional live streams that are highly interactive. You can use it to bring on live interview guests, stream across multiple platforms simultaneously. And if you want to get started with Streamyard, you can use the link in the description to get a $10 credit for whatever plan works best for you. All right, let's set up your YouTube live stream with Streamyard the right way. There's a couple key features that will help you maximize the viewership of your live streams. So step number one is you're going to want to connect your YouTube channel to Streamyard. To do this, simply click destinations and add a destination. You're going to select YouTube channel and then click your YouTube channel and connect everything on the back end. Next, you're going to want to click create your broadcast and select your YouTube channel. I'm going to set up a stream for Think Media, but you can see the cool thing here with Streamyard is you can connect multiple different accounts across platforms. I have Facebook pages, Facebook groups, other YouTube channels, and this gives you the opportunity to multi-stream if you would like. I'm just going to set up a YouTube live stream for Think Media, and you're going to want to enter your title, your description, and you're going to want to make sure that it's public. This way, it will be visible for everyone to start getting ready for the live stream. And a huge key for live streams to do well is scheduling it for later. I think if you can do this a day ahead of time or around 12 hours ahead of time, or even just at least an hour or a few hours, what I'll schedule is this for today at 1 in the afternoon, PM Pacific Standard Time. This gives people the chance to see that the broadcast is coming up. It'll start showing up in their subscription feed. So this is super powerful. You also can upload your thumbnail image at this point. And so this, of course, is one of the most powerful things to do to get attention to your live stream. If you set up your live stream wrong, a lot of times it just has kind of a default image or your default channel image. This allows you to build buzz with a quality thumbnail that you design ahead of time. And you can fill out your description here, but I'm actually going to do that in the next step because we're going to move into YouTube Studio once we schedule this stream. So now when the video is public and you click create broadcast, the video will be in subscribers' feeds and will be on the internet shareable with a YouTube link with a countdown to your live stream. But we now need to set it up at a deeper level inside of YouTube Studio. To do that, we're going to click content in the back end of our YouTube channel. We're going to click live, and we're going to go to the upcoming stream right here. Lean in at this part because we have the ability to dial in some really cool features. Next, you're gonna click view in live control room, and this will take you into the back end of the stream. Once I get inside of here, I wanna make sure I click the box, no, it's not made for kids, unless of course your live stream is intended for kids, just honestly answer that question. I also wanna make sure that monetization is enabled, so make sure that you click that on if you're eligible for monetization. And then a very important feature that isn't on by default is enable auto stop. So enable auto start means that when you click on the back end of StreamYard go live, it will instantly go live on the YouTube channel. But if you turn it off on StreamYard, it'll actually still be streaming unless you have enable auto stop clicked on. So that's a setting we use all the time here at Think Media so that we have total control inside of StreamYard to start and stop the stream. The alternative way to do it is to go live in StreamYard, but then you'd have to also come into YouTube Studio in the back end here and make sure that you click go live. So it sort of becomes two steps. And by checking those two tabs, it becomes one step. Next, I'm gonna go back to YouTube Studio and I'm gonna go back into the live stream to finish out preparation. For this part, I'm gonna click details, and this will allow me to make sure that the title is correct. And at this point, I will fill out my description. Now we have a default description that reminds us to put a keyword phrase and kind of an opening declaration, well-written, of what the live stream will be about. a link to any playlist, affiliate, or sponsor, disclaimers, as well as show notes labeled with emojis that can be filled in with any details ahead of time before the live stream even starts, and some other default description information. And additionally, I also now have the chance to add tags, which gives the video more data before I ever go live about exactly what it's about. So one way to think about doing a live stream strategically like this is the idea that you're basically creating a video in reverse. If you know what you're going to talk about, you know what the title is, you've created the thumbnail, you know what the tags are, and you filled out your YouTube description so that as you go live, you might mention resources or tools or calls to action that you know you're gonna say, you've just thought about them ahead of time and made sure that the video was optimized for that live stream. But don't go anywhere, because I have three tips to share with you that will help you boost your broadcast and get more views on your live stream. But if you've been getting value, smash the like button. And let me pass the question off to you. Have you gone live before? What is your method of going live? Software, mobile, desktop? What tools do you use? Let me know in the comments section below. So tip number one for getting more views on your live stream is make sure to schedule it and promote it ahead of time. Streamyard makes it really easy to set up. You can see that this video is scheduled again for 1 p.m. and I can actually grab my YouTube link right here, and that link is the countdown to the live stream. You can see live in 112 minutes. And now if I want to share that link, I could craft a post, for example, over here on Twitter, upload the thumbnail that I've pre-designed and say, I'm going live soon, and share that link. And when people click through, they'll see the countdown, they can turn on notifications, and it's a great way to build momentum leading into your live. The second tip, going deeper on scheduling, is the reason it's powerful to schedule your live stream ahead of time and optimize it ahead of time is YouTube sends out notifications. And so typically YouTube is going to send out a notification to your subscribers at 1 hour, I think with a few minutes before your live stream and when you're live. But if you don't schedule it, you're not kind of warming up your audience and building up that momentum ahead of time. That's why I like to say, if possible, schedule your live stream over an hour earlier, because you want YouTube to be able to kind of set it up, understand it, and then when you hit that 60-minute mark, boom, a notification goes out, and then whatever other notifications go out, and it helps you, again, build momentum so more people can be there live and that the video can take off for the replay value as well. And tip number three is optimize it for the replay. So when you're finally ready to go live, you're going to be in your StreamYard backend, you're going to enter Broadcast Studio here. This will give you a chance to select your camera, your microphone, your display name, and then enter into your Broadcast Studio. Now I'm actually using my camera to record this on my computer, so that's why it says device not connected. But once you're ready to go live here, again, because we turned on auto off and auto on in the upper right hand corner, when we click go live, it'll go live. When we click end stream, it'll end the stream. And we have all the other features, which if you want to learn a little bit more about StreamYard, you can click or tap the YouTube card or look at the playlist in the description, where we'll break down some of the tools and features in the background here. And again, the reason I like to be able to click live and instantly be live and click end stream and instantly end the stream is tip number three, optimize your live streams for the replay. What does that mean? It means that when you start the video, I like to open right up with a hook for the replay viewers, right? A lot of times we click live and we say, is anybody here? All right, we're gonna get started soon. All right, no one's on yet. All right, we'll wait for a few minutes. Hey everyone, here's kind of what's been happening before I get into the main content. And while that might have more of a truly live flavor to it, there's no replay value on that. So by setting up StreamYard in this way, I click go live and I go 0 to 100 real quick. I wanna open up with a strong hook, strong content. And I also like to use terms in the video. I like to say, if you're watching on the replay, leave me a comment below. Sometimes I even address chat as comments, like leave me a comment, because it kind of means chat, but it really means leave me a comment for the replay, because it's kind of two different sets of language. And this is another reason why having a title ahead of time, a searchable title, a well-written title, good tags, that also makes the video potentially live way beyond the live. At Think Media, we have so many videos that rank in search that were live streams, that get views for weeks, months, and even years to come that were live streams because of following this idea of optimizing your live stream for the replay viewer. And if you actually want to learn a little bit more about that and you haven't seen our free masterclass, you can go to thinkmasterclass.com, or we'll link that to that in the description down below, to think through your videos, think through your titles, and basically create a live stream that's meant to be searched and watched on replay, so you get a lot more value out of it beyond just going live. But we have only scratched the surface on the power of Streamyard. Yes, now it's set up to go live on YouTube, but if you want a full tutorial of how to do branding, upload videos, how to bring on guests, and all the cool features that Streamyard has, just click or tap the screen to watch that video. Or for another video from Think Media, just click or tap the screen, and I will see you in the next one.